enter into this building. You brought your burdens, you brought your pain, but I have a message for you today. That when you leave here, you won't be the same. So you tell me, you've been to your physician, but look at you, there's been no change in your condition. Reach out and touch the master's robe. There's healing for your mind, oh, your body and oh, your soul. Oh, yes, there is. Hallelujah. God can heal.
God can heal.
Oh, yeah. And he can mend a broken
man. He can mend your brokenness.
He has
the miracle to fit your needs.
Won't you trust?
Won't you trust him?
Oh, then you will receive. About your situation, but with every test and every trial, there is revelation that God is able to supply every one of your needs. He's here to touch you, heal you.
Everyone on this first Sunday in May, we give praise to God our Father and Jesus our only, his only begotten Son. Scripture this morning is coming from the book of Ephesians, the second chapter, beginning at the 14th verse. For he himself is our peace, who has made both one and has broken down the middle wall of separation, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, that is the law of commandments contained in the ordinance, so as to create in himself one new man from the two, thus making peace, and that he might reconcile them both to God in the body through the cross, therefore putting to death the enmity between man and God. And he came and preached peace to you and with above and those who were near. For through him, we both have access by one Spirit to the Father. Let us come this morning and give thanks to God for all the many blessings that he has given unto us. We say, thank you, dear Father, for your Son, Jesus Christ, whom you allowed to be crucified, whom you allowed to be nailed to a tree, whom you allowed, O Heavenly Father, to be pierced inside, whom you allowed, O Heavenly Father, the sun to stop shining so they would not see, O Heavenly Father, the wretchedness of your Son, Jesus Christ. And, O Lord, when you put him in the tomb, O Lord, you gave him power. Power, O Heavenly Father, to come out of the tomb. With resurrection power, O Heavenly Father, he stood on the ground on the first day of the week. So we say thank you today, dear Heavenly Father, that you've given us, O Heavenly Father, in him. Peace, O Heavenly Father, beyond our understanding. Peace, he said he had given unto us. Not as the world be of peace, but peace, O Heavenly Father, from you, O Heavenly Father, and the Holy Spirit, O Heavenly Father, that enabled us. We say thank you this morning. Thank you, dear Lord, for your Son, O Heavenly Father, who, O Heavenly Father, came to in this world, O Heavenly Father, to save sinners such as we. O Heavenly Father, he came, O Heavenly Father, and gave himself, O Heavenly Father, a ransom for men. We were as scattered sheep, O Heavenly Father. O Heavenly Father, he came, O Heavenly Father, that he might be our great shepherd. O Heavenly Father, he healed, O Heavenly Father, those, O Heavenly Father, that he came in contact with, O Lord. And O Heavenly Father, there was no one, O Heavenly Father, outside of his healing power and outside the preaching, O Heavenly Father, of the kingdom of God. O Lord, you are holy. O Lord, we bless you, O Heavenly Father, that your kingdom come, O Heavenly Father, into this earth, O Heavenly Father, as it is in heaven. O Heavenly Father, we give thanks, O Heavenly Father, that you give us our daily bread, O Heavenly Father, the food, O Heavenly Father, of your word, Lord. Not, O Heavenly Father, the food, O Heavenly Father, that go in and come out, Lord, but the food, O Heavenly Father, that nourish our spirit. The food, O Heavenly Father, that give us insight into the mysteries, O Heavenly Father, of your Son, Jesus Christ. And of you, O Heavenly Father, who loved us so much, O Heavenly Father, that you gave us your only begotten Son. That through him, O Heavenly Father, we will have access to the tree of life, O Lord. So we say thank you. For you have given us, O Heavenly Father, great and precious promises, O Heavenly Father, in heaven. That through your Son, Jesus Christ, all things would be made perfect to us, O Heavenly Father. On that day, O Heavenly Father, when you break through the clouds once again and say, O Heavenly Father, it is your Son, Jesus Christ, O Heavenly Father, that you gave judgment to. And we know, Lord, in this day and in this time, O Heavenly Father, we are being judged, O Heavenly Father, because of the things, O Heavenly Father, that we are doing. We, O Heavenly Father, give credence, O Heavenly Father, to homosexuality in your house, Lord. Heavenly such, O Lord. We come, O Heavenly Father, with our eyes blind, O Heavenly Father, to those things, O Heavenly Father, that you do not allow in your house. We are supposed to be worshiping, praising you, O Lord, lifting you up, O Heavenly Father, giving you the glory. But we, O Heavenly Father, have become materialistic, O Heavenly Father, as in the day of Rome, O Lord, as in the day of Noah, O Heavenly Father, as in the day of Moses, Lord. All these things, O Heavenly Father, that happened to them, O Lord, were happening to us today. As Sodom and Gomorrah, O Heavenly Father, was judged, O Lord. One of these days, O Heavenly Father, you would judge America, or you would give an account, O Heavenly Father, to us being, O Heavenly Father, so sinful, O Lord, that you would not put us to death also. We thank you this morning, Lord. We praise your holy name, Lord Jesus. And we thank you, O Heavenly Father, that the government, O Heavenly Father, though they be writing, O Heavenly Father, different ordinances, O Heavenly Father, for different people, Lord, we come and say, thank you, Lord. But, O Heavenly Father, we need you, Lord, the only true government, O Heavenly Father, to come, O Heavenly Father, into our heart, into our mind and our souls, O Lord, to give us the peace, O Heavenly Father, beyond understanding, Lord, that we, O Heavenly Father, would be just like Jesus, Lord. Humble, O Heavenly Father, ourselves in your hand that you might lift us up and not those, O Heavenly Father, of this world. We thank you, O Heavenly Father, that we come, O Heavenly Father, to, O Heavenly Father, partake of your Son's broken body, O Heavenly Father, of his shed blood. That, O Heavenly Father, in doing so, O Lord, we give remembrance, O Heavenly Father, that he came, O Lord. And when he preached, O Heavenly Father, the word, O Heavenly Father, of peace, O Lord, that our lives were made much better. Our souls, O Heavenly Father, were lifted up. Our lives, O Heavenly Father, continue, O Heavenly Father, to be in his hand, O Heavenly Father. Though we be burdened down, O Heavenly Father, we're not cast out. Though we be burdened down, O Heavenly Father, we have yet, O Heavenly Father, to move and have our being in him. Who came, O Heavenly Father, and died that we might have life, O Heavenly Father. So we say thank you, Lord. Bless you, O Lord. Bless you, Lord Jesus, as you come and bless our souls, O Heavenly Father, with the peace beyond understanding, O Lord. And, O Heavenly Father, we thank you for these individuals, O Heavenly Father, these cities, Lord, that have seen, O Heavenly Father, the policemen, O Heavenly Father, being brought to trial, O Heavenly Father, for being indifferent toward those that are not of their color, O Lord, not in their, O Heavenly Father, organization, Lord Jesus, and not, O Heavenly Father, on the same realm, O Heavenly Father, as they are. We give thanks, O Heavenly Father, for the presidency, O Heavenly Father, of the United States at this time. Oh, Lord, as they continue to work, oh, Heavenly Father, through this pandemic, oh, Lord, to bring about, oh, Heavenly Father, a peaceful end, oh, Lord. But we know, Heavenly Father, all healing, oh, Heavenly Father, come from you. Oh, Lord, all healing come from your Son. Oh, Lord, all healing, oh, Heavenly Father, come through the Word, oh, Lord. Give us, oh, Heavenly Father, hearing ears, oh, Heavenly Father, and an entertaining heart, Lord, that we might go, oh, Lord. Go forth, O Heavenly Father, and receive that which you've allowed, O Heavenly Father, to give us comfort, O Heavenly Father, in this pandemic. O Lord, the shackles are free, O Heavenly Father, but your love is free, O Lord, because you gave us the freedom of his death, O Heavenly Father. You gave us the freedom, O Heavenly Father, of his being raised up, that we might be raised up with him one day, O Lord. And we say thank you. Thank you for the pastor of this church, Lord. Thank you, O Heavenly Father, that you give him strength, O Heavenly Father, as he give you glory, O Heavenly Father, by presenting the Word, O Heavenly Father. The Word, O Heavenly Father, that was crucified for your Son, Jesus, but raised that we might all might have eternal life in him. And we say thank you. Thank you, dear Lord, for this city. Thank you for this church body, most of all, O Lord, that your Word continue to move and abide in them, O Lord, as we, O Heavenly Father, go forth, O Heavenly Father. One by one, O Heavenly Father, in the direction that you would desire us to go. Placing your Word in our heart, your Word in our mind, O Lord, your Word in our spirit, Lord, that all things, O Heavenly Father, would be, O Heavenly Father, Jesus Christ, and not of the world, because it is yet becoming darker. Dark, O Heavenly Father, but we have the guiding light, the light of your Son, O Heavenly Father, whom we lift up this day, O Lord. It's in his name we come this morning, O Lord. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I just be waiting. Yes, Lord. So by the time that you leave this building, my prayer for everyone in here is that you'll have your healing. Once God works a miracle to feed your needs, go tell the world, oh, what you have received. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Lord has healed,
oh, yeah.
He has healed,
and you've mended my.
Please say good morning as we assemble on this first Sunday of May. Around the table, we thank God for what he's done for us. Paul writes these words in 1 Corinthians 11, I have given you the teaching I received from the Lord. The night Jesus was handed over to the soldiers, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take this bread and eat it. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this to remember me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He said, this cup is the new way of worship made between God and you by my blood. Whenever you drink it, do it to remember me. Every time you eat this bread and drink from this cup, you are telling of the Lord's death until he comes again.
Amen.
Anyone who eats the bread or drink from the cup, if his spirit is not right with the Lord, will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord.
Amen.
This is why a man should look into his own heart.
Yes.
And life,
yes,
before,
yes,
eating the bread and drinking from the cup.
Amen.
Anyone who eats the bread and drinks from the cup, if his spirit is not right with the Lord, he is guilty as he eats and drinks. He does not understand the meaning of the Lord's body. This is why some of you are sick and weak, and some have died. But if we would look into our own lives,
yes,
and see if we are guilty, then God would not have to say we are guilty.
Jason.
But we are guilty. We are punished by the Lord.
Yes.
So we will not be told, we are guilty with the rest of the world.
Yes, Lord.
Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you for being God all by yourself.
No, true, Lord Jesus.
Now, Lord, if we come together to eat and drink of this body and the blood of Jesus, we thank you for saving our very souls. Yes. We thank you for what Jesus done for us back on Calvary's cross, that we will believe in him and have everlasting life. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
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 Bless the Lord.
On that night when Jesus was with the disciples, the Bible says he took bread, he broke it, and he gave thanks. Father, we just thank you for the broken body of Jesus. For we know by his stripes we are healed. Let us eat together.
Your love. Your love.
Likewise, he took the cup. When he poured, he said, this represents the New Testament, my blood.
My blood.
As often as you do this, you do it in remembrance of me. Father, we just thank you for the shed blood of Jesus, the blood that covered our sins and made us white as snow. Let us drink together.
Amen.
After supper was over, Jesus and the disciples departed and went on the Mount of Olives, and there was a king. Lead us there. So let you.
From the Lord,
I have my soul.
you, Father, for your power. It has resurrected me over painful circumstances that my poor soul could not flee.
Today is a new day, and it's filled with difficult possibilities.
Yeah.
I pray that you, O Lord, perform miracles in the life of your people. I thank you for your many blessings.
Yes,
I pray you bless and fill Mount Zion with, and all your children with love, peace, and prosperity. Yes. I also pray for joy, abundance, and strength. I pray for great health and continued healing. I pray for our loved ones. I pray for your loving kindness and mercy. I pray for your guidance and protection. Father in heaven, I stand before you today in your all-powerful presence to ask that you grant me the strength and power to proclaim your word to your people. Lord, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. For you, O Lord, are my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And amen.
The Lord.
Again, we greet you in the name of our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For we are blessed people to have such a mighty God. On today, we want to invite you to the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 8 and 9, reading from the New King James Version. 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 8 and 9. When you discover it, you find these words: we are hard pressed on every side. Yet not crushed.
Yes.
We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Thus in the reading of God's word. On this day, we want to talk to you from this subject: down, but not out.
Amen.
Down, but not out. The New Living Translation of the text read, we are pressed on every side by troubles, but we are not crushed. We are perplexed, but not driven to despair. We are hunted down, but never abandoned by God. We are not down, but we are not destroyed. The question is, have you ever been in a place in your life where you felt down and out?
Yes, Lord.
Where you felt pinned in, hemmed in,
on all sides, Lord.
Jammed in,
yeah.
Trapped in. At a place where you felt immobilized with no way out, we encourage you to let these Holy Spirit inspired words spoken by Paul to stir up your faith in God. Listen to him as recorded in the New Life Version. We are pressed on every side, but we still have room to move. We are often in much trouble, but we never give up. People make it hard for us, but we are not left alone. We are not down, but we are not destroyed.
Amen.
In my mind's eye, I believe what Paul was trying to say in the text is that through ever our circumstances may leave us trouble on every side, if we walk by faith, we will not be distressed.
That's right. Amen.
Even though your feelings tell you that you should feel perplexed, with the free dictionary.com definition as feel with confusion or bewildered, feel with complaints or difficulties, completely baffled, very puzzled, confused and worried at a loss. So even though you are worried and at a loss in your trouble,
yeah.
Paul reminds us in Philippians 4:6, don't worry about anything.
Pray.
Instead, pray about everything.
Everything.
Tell God what you need.
Yes, Lord.
And thank him for all he has done. You see, if you cry out to Jesus, you will not have to cry out in despair. Because even in persecution, he is there. Even when you are cast down by the enemy, shake it off and get up because his hand is upon you.
Amen.
He will not let you be destroyed.
Amen.
As believers in Jesus Christ, the encouragement that we want to bring to you is this. Just because you may be down, it does not mean that you have to be counted out.
Yes.
The text is a testimony of confidence. It says to us that we, when we face the trials and troubles of life, even the hardest times of life, when we go through the battles, we might get knocked down,
yes,
but we do not have to be knocked out.
Yes.
The wise one write, for a man who is right with God falls 7 times and rises again, but the sinful fall in time of trouble. Proverbs 24:16. Isaiah chimes in with these words, have you not known? Have you not heard?
Yes.
The God who lives forever is the Lord. The one who makes the end of the earth. He will not become weak or tired. His understanding is too great for us to begin to know. He gives strength to the weak.
Yeah.
And he gives power to him who has little strength. Even very young people get tired and become weak. And strong young men trip and fall. But they who wait upon the Lord will get new strength. They will rise up with wings like eagles.
Yeah.
They will run and not get tired. They will walk and not become weak. Isaiah 40:28-31.
Yes, Lord.
So if you feel yourself at a place where there is no rest, all kinds of attacks, battles, conflict, and struggles on the outside, and chaos, confusion, disorder, and fear on the inside, Yet in the midst of your troubles and trials, we declare this confidence declaration. You might be down, but not out. And in your time of trouble, you can attain peace with Jesus Christ. Do you know the peace found only in Jesus Christ? John records these words of Jesus. I have told you all this so that you might have peace in me. Here on the earth, you will have many trials and sorrows. But take heart, because I have overcome the world. John 16:33. See, Jesus said that in him is where you will find peace. Everybody says there's trouble in the world, but I want you to know that there is peace in Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
These words of Jesus warns us of the tribulation to come, and then he says, do not worry. Just find peace in me.
Yeah.
When you are weary, find rest in me. When the going get tough, I will give you refuge and your strength. Take heart and be of good cheer.
Amen.
Rejoice and be glad, because the joy of the Lord is your strength. I need you to know he is all powerful. He is almighty. He's able to do exceeding abundant all we ask or think.
Amen.
He's able to turn those stumbling blocks into stepping stones.
Yes, he can.
He is not moved by circumstances. Our God is moved by faith.
Nothing impossible.
You see, if you apply your faith to what the scripture promises, and you believe in your heart, and not only believe it, but speak it, then you'll be able to attain the peace of Jesus Christ from the promise of the word.
Yes, you can.
No matter what your test, trial, or trouble, by faith, you can attain God's peace, which goes beyond anything we can imagine. Will guard your thoughts and emotions through Christ. Philippians 4:7. In this past year, we have all had some real downtime.
Yes,
at times we were down, but not out. Because God has given us every spiritual blessing in heaven. Paul says in Ephesians 1:3, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ.
Yes, he has.
The words, every spiritual blessing, encouraged my heart, because the Greek word for blessing means benefit.
These benefits
are spiritual blessings through Jesus Christ, as revealed in Ephesians 1:4-19. In verse 4, we are chosen before the foundation of the world.
Yeah.
To know you have been chosen before the foundation of the world is to know that your life matters.
Yeah.
Your existence is not an accident or a byproduct of natural selection. God has been thinking about your destiny before he even said, let there be light. Also, holy and blameless.
Holy.
In Jesus Christ, we are holy and blameless. This means you are fit to serve him and worship him despite your shortcomings.
Kingdom.
God enjoys you, encourages you to come to him and approach him and to walk with him and then touch each other, not because of our own righteousness, but because of the righteousness of Jesus Christ that has been imputed and attributed
his
to you.
Righteousness.
Also, in his love.
Yes,
in Jesus Christ, we stand in agape, or unconditional love.
So
you cannot earn it.
So
you are unconditionally loved in him.
Yeah.
In verse 5, we are predestined to the adoption.
God has predestined to call us His own in Jesus Christ. He has selected you to be His son or daughter. You are part of His family. He is your father. Many times when parents adopt a child, they go through a selection process for making the decision of who they will adopt and who they will not. God already went through the process and He has determined that you are His child. He made the selection a long time ago. And He decided to adopt you as one of His children. In verse 6, we are accepted in the beloved. You are not rejected. You are not an outcast. You are not unworthy of approval. The Creator of the universe accepted you in Jesus Christ. You have been relationally reconciled in Jesus Christ and are pleasing to God. You might not have wealth in all your relationship right now, but in Jesus Christ, there is nothing between you and God. In verse 7, we have redemption through His blood. Outside of Jesus Christ, you were a slave to sin and eternal death. You could not buy or earn your way out of it. The price for your freedom was the precious blood of Jesus. Jesus was not a slave. Jesus was already free. But Jesus paid the price for our freedom in a way. And you all are shouting, hallelujah. Forgiveness of sin. In our life, we all have turned our back on God's morally. We have consistently rebelled against His law in our heart. We have ignored His wisdom. And through our own selves, we thought that we are wiser more than Him many times. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. In verse 7 and 8, we have the riches of His grace abounding towards us. Grace means unmerited favor. Abound means to have in abundance. In Jesus Christ, there is an abundance measure of unmerited favor flowing to your life like a river that will last from here into never ending depths of eternity. And if you don't mind, I just need to pause. I'm so glad that there is an abundance of unmerited favor of grace coming through Jesus Christ. In verse 9, God made known to us the mystery of His will. In a fallen world of war, suffering and disease, a sinful world where bad things happen to good people, God has revealed His solution to us. He has unwrapped every answer to every aspect of human condition in Jesus Christ, and He gave it to us. In verse 11, we attain an eternal inheritance. Revelation 21:4 describes heaven in the following manner. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, no more sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be no pain, for the former things have passed away. In verse 13, we have heard the word of truth. God's truth is the light in darkness. We are not without counsel. We are not left in the dark. We have heard His good news and discovered the path of life. Also, sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. The promise of the Holy Spirit that was prophesied by Isaiah, Ezekiel, Zechariah, Joel, John the Baptist, and Jesus Christ have been made to us and available to us. In verse 18, We know the hope of his calling.
Yes, Lord.
His calling over our life is a basket you can put all your heads in. It is an anchor. It is on a rock. It will never end in vain. Also, we are the riches of his inheritance.
Yes, Lord.
You are of great value to Jesus.
Yeah.
As he brought you back to God, God gave you back to Jesus as an inheritance. You are valuable in Christ. You are the righteous of God in Christ. You are his eternal reward, and he cherishes you.
Yes, he does.
In verses 19 and 20, we have the exceeding greatness of his power. Paul said, the exceeding greatness of his power is toward us who believe. What kind of power is this? It is the same power that raised Jesus from the dead.
Holy Ghost.
It is the same power that conquers sin.
Yeah.
It is the same power that conquered death. It is the same power that conquered hell. In Jesus Christ, this same power is present in your life today.
Amen.
So I have just one question for you.
Yes.
Are you blessed today?
Yes, Lord.
So if you are blessed, you might be down, but you are not out. And you may like what Louise Camden Davis declared. I am blessed, better than blessed. Praise the Lord. I may not have houses and wealth. I may not have all my strength and health, but I am blessed, better than blessed. Praise the Lord. Many times I had to learn my lesson, for I did not appreciate my blessing. I complained that I had no shoes. Then I saw a man who had no feet to use.
Lord Jesus.
And I know I am blessed, better than blessed. Thank you, Lord. I got God the Father walking before me.
Yeah.
I got God, his Son, Jesus Christ, walking behind me. I have got the Holy Spirit within me. And I have got all of God's angels around me. I know I am blessed. Better than blessed. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah, Lord.
Because of his blessings, I have been down, but not out. It's good to know that it does not matter how many times you get knocked down, you can be down but not out.
Yeah.
And the good thing about this is the fact that when you get knocked down, you can get back up. You may not have your full balance and composure, but just the mere effort of you trying to get up grabs God's immediate attention.
Yes, Lord.
Your effort is trying to get you up. It excites God because your weakness presents God an opportunity to show up. The Bible teaches us that it is in our weakest state that God's strength is made perfect. And because of the fact that God always shows up in our weakest moment, every time we get knocked down in life by some tribulation, by some disappointment, by some heartbreak, by some trial we go through every day, as long as we get back up, the fight is not over yet. Oh, I believe that there are some fighters listening to me right now. You may not know that you are a fighter, but just the simple fact that you are still here, still holding on in spite of the he and double L you've gone through, tells me that you are a fighter. Life will throw an unexpected blow and knock you clean off your feet. Have you ever been hit with something in life that left you totally numb? A fighter can train all he or she can, but in the being the best shape of life, and still get hit and knocked down by an unexpected punch. This is also true with us. It does not matter how much Bible you know, nor does it matter how strong and prayed up you are. Life will hit you with a blow that will literally knock you senseless.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Don't get me wrong. It pays to be prayed up.
Yes, it does.
It pays to study and learn the word, because that is your training ground. And it is according to how well a fighter trains that determines how fast the recovery is from a serious knockdown. It is not that we are never beaten, but we are never utterly defeated. We may lose the battle, but if you know like I know, we are not going to lose the war. We may be knocked down, but we are not knocked out. David declared that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. Though he falls, he shall not utterly be cast down, for the Lord upholds him in his hand. Psalms 37:23-24. I wonder, is there anybody that believes like me? You know that you are born to make it through the trouble of life because God is with you. You know that sometimes you are down, but not out. No matter what comes my way, I can declare that I am a survivor. I am a survivor because the Lord was and is with me. You see, because of his presence, I am a survivor of this. I am a survivor of that. I am a survivor of the other. I am blessed and excited about what the Lord has brought me through and what he's going to do in my life. You see, after all the he and double L I have been through, I am still here. I'm still in my right mind. I still have my joy of the Lord and in the Lord. And no matter what comes, I still have breath to give praise to God. The William Brothers says these words, I have seen too many victories to let defeat have the last word. When I wake up in the morning and realize that I am, that I'm still here, that lets me know that God gave me favor no matter what circumstances reveal. He brought me through my pains and sorrow, reassuring I got hope for tomorrow. Defeat cannot compete with mercy and grace. I am just kept by faith. I can win the race. When I think of his goodness and all he's done for me, I dare not complain, because he brought me through over the rugged hills, all my heartaches and pains. Well, I understand trials come to make me strong.
Yes, Lord.
I got to stay in the race. I got to keep pressing on. This is my testimony to you. I got victory, even though I do not look like what I've been through. When I wake up in the morning, I count it victory. I get out of my bed, I count it victory. I put one foot before the other, I count it victory. My peace of mind, I count it victory. All of my suffering, I count it victory. Suffering that I went through, I count it victory. Through all of my struggles I'm going through, I count it victory. I gotta tell you, every breath that I take, I count it victory. Every move that I make, I count it victory. And every word that I speak, I count it victory. The pain that I endured, I count it victory. So I declare to you today, down the that he will take care of us. I'm glad that he said all we have to do is bring all our trials to him, and he will make our load lighter. Yes, yes, we get down sometimes, but we are never out when we have Jesus in our life. If you don't mind, if you got anybody next to you, just hug them and say, you can be down.
You can be down.
But you are not out.
You're not cast out.
Because they tried to count out Jesus.
Yes, they did.
But they messed up counting him out.
Yes,
they hung him on a whole rugged cross. Yes, they took him down and put him in a tomb. And then they rolled a stone up against the tomb.
Surely,
they placed soldiers at the tomb to make sure no one stole his body. But while they were looking on the outside, Jesus was on the inside, counting down but not out. He went down to hell, took the sting out of death, rose up on that first day of the week with all power in his hand. I can just imagine in my sanctified mind, he's raised up saying, you thought I was out, but I want you to know I have all power in heaven and in earth. And therefore, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. No matter what troubles come your way, you may get down, but you are not out, because you got Jesus, and Jesus alone will take care.
He will take care. Of
tell somebody, it's okay to be down.
Yes, it is.
But never give up, because Jesus will rescue you.
Pick me up, Lord.
Amen.
Pick me up.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. On this day, we give God praise.
Praise you
for being
name,
such
Lord
a
Jesus.
Great God. For when I did not know which way to go, he already made
it.
When I walked up to a door that was closed in my face, he had already opened up another door for me to walk through. And I want you to know today, all you have to do is turn it over to Jesus. Because you can, with him, you can be down, but not out. If you got a church on,
amen,
we invite you to come. You can come by letter, Christian experience, Catholic baptism. All you have to do is give your life to him.
Give it to
and
him.
And know that he will take care of
he
you.
He will take care.
Now him is able to keep you from falling. Give us your faultless for his trouble, see you joy. Through our lives, God is our Savior. Amen. Now empower and all the saints of God says, amen.
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 From the Lord, did you hear me say, I'm a vessel, you're a vessel full of power, you got power from the Lord. Always know who